Hi, this is Tom Craven from RRAMAC Connected Systems. Today I'm going to talk about leveraging the Industrial Internet of Things to reduce operating costs in water and wastewater facilities. Most water and wastewater plants have been using some sort of SCADA system to monitor their operations for about the past 2 or 3 decades. However, these systems can be challenging for a lot of municipal customers due to the amount of technical support they require, the overall maintenance of the software, and the overall cost of maintaining the systems. And although they give you a very good idea of what's currently happening in your facility, most systems are not really giving you access to downtime information or ways to reduce energy costs, chemical costs, or help maintain compliance. Like most other industries, water and wastewater plants are being asked to do more and more with fewer and fewer people. Consequently, most of these facilities lack either the technical expertise or simply the time to maintain the SCADA systems and the associated software, whether that's a historian or SQL database, porting systems, and those sorts of things. So when some sort of software error occurs, the maintenance people at the plant typically have to make a phone call to technical support. Troubleshooting over a phone call is not a very efficient way to troubleshoot software. The problem is the support engineer on the other end of the phone has no visibility into your system. This problem goes away if you go with a cloud-hosted system. This is because the software is actually running on the software provider's servers. You're just logging into it. So if there's a software error, the service provider, in most cases, can take care of that before you're even aware of it. Now, when you do have to call in, the support engineer has full access to see everything that you're seeing, and you can walk through it together. So with the cloud-hosted system, there are no servers to put on site, no software licenses to purchase, no software installs or upgrades, no database to maintain, and all of that is managed by the software company. So now let's shift gears here and get into the meat of cost savings and compliance issues. These plants have to run 24/7, so downtime is a huge deal. What happens with a cloud system, the downtime reporting is very easily added into the system. You get the same screens, the same navigation as the rest of your facility, but you can do interactive reports. So what you see on the screen here is downtime reasons over an operator-selected time period. And you can quickly see on a Pareto chart the number one cause or what's causing the most minutes of downtime over the selected period. You can also drill down into individual process areas or individual pieces of equipment to look at downtime. Maybe you want to look at the number of faults versus accumulated time. You have those capabilities in a cloud-hosted system with downtime. The next step beyond downtime is predictive maintenance. And that goes beyond just measuring when something failed. The idea is to prevent the failures from happening in the first place. This is extremely difficult to manage on site and rarely happens without outside help. With a cloud-hosted system, you can get information to experts. There's a case study I'm showing on the screen here. You can also download this. You can download our predictive maintenance brochure off of our website. But this is an example where a wastewater company saved $150,000 annually by predicting the individual failures. Energy usage is a huge cost for most water facilities in particular. The cloud system can include reports on a daily, weekly, monthly basis, or interact with the energy reports on an as-needed basis. But you can see the total energy used by each piece of equipment in your facility. You can look at the historical usage. You can get alerts if a piece of equipment is using more current than typically has, or if your overall plant is approaching a peak demand requirement. Here again, we can use some artificial intelligence to do modeling of the system and actually help you optimize. So for example, if you want to know, is your plant more efficient at a particular flow rate running 2 constant speed pumps and 1 VFD or 2 VFDs and 1 constant speed pump, that can be analyzed over time and recommendations can be made or even acted on within the software. Chemical costs are a huge part of the budget for many water and wastewater facilities. You can't afford to run out of the chemicals, but the cost of keeping multiple barrels of chemicals on site can be expensive. If you start to run low, you might end up having to pay expedite fees. So monitoring chemical usage is critical. What happens with a cloud-hosted system is it can tie in not only to your control system to monitor the PLC accessed tank levels, but it can also tie into your inventory system and know how much chemical is on site already and can trigger alerts based on the current usage rates, based on historical usage of those chemicals, and can predict when you're going to run out, and in fact can tie into your ordering system and automatically reorder chemicals. This is a great example of just-in-time ordering. It's also possible to optimize the chemical usage, again using system modeling and artificial intelligence, so that you can look at what you need to do to maintain compliance with the minimum amount of chemicals, and that can be learned and implemented over time through artificial intelligence. So the last slide I have here is dealing with compliance reports. Obviously, maintaining the chemical inventory is a compliance issue. Avoiding downtime with downtime reporting and predictive maintenance all ties into compliance. But the reports themselves have to be generated. And so your monthly usage reports, those can be generated on the cloud server and can be in PDF format that you can download and print from any HTML5 compatible browser. You can also automatically email those out to wherever they need to go. Let's talk a little bit about reliability and cybersecurity. The reliability of the system in a traditional SCADA is typically dependent on a single server or a single PC that's collecting the data. In cloud-hosted systems, redundant servers are the norm. So you're looking at redundant servers in a data center, typically multiple locations, so you're not dependent on one building. Redundant edge nodes are an option if you want two communication paths through two physical devices or two communication paths for data coming over your local network or with a backup over cellular modems. The offsite data backup service is included in your fee, so you're not managing the on-site backups. And the web dashboards are available on any PC with a HTML5 compatible browser. Now, from a cybersecurity standpoint, the SCADA systems in a facility typically are less secure than what you have in a hosted system. That's because the cloud-hosted system is always managed by cybersecurity experts. The SCADA server typically is managed by maintenance people in the building that typically are not, it's not that they don't have knowledge or information, but it's not their full-time job to be cybersecurity experts. A lot of the systems that are running in water and wastewater plants don't always get the latest operating system upgrades, virus patches, etc., because people try and keep those, in some cases, completely disconnected from the internet. But that's not really a realistic expectation anymore. You have to connect to the internet to get the upgrades, to get to the latest software, or you're transferring it through a USB stick. And many viruses, many security breaches start with somebody connecting a USB device to their PCs or servers. So there's a lot more I can say on this topic, but if you want more information on cybersecurity, you can get to our website, RRAMAC.com/resources, and download the Industry 4.0 Cybersecurity Dilemma webinar that we've put together. So you'll find that on our website if you want to dig deeper into security, or by all means, give us a call. We're always happy to chat on the subject. So in summary, the benefits of using a cloud-hosted system versus traditional SCADA: the cloud system has a lower upfront cost. It has a lower overall annual cost. You don't have to have IT support locally at the plants in order to maintain it. The IT support comes with the system from the software provider. You have higher system availability because of all the redundancy and backup power built into the data servers and the data center that they're located in. You have improved cybersecurity, and you have options for cost reduction by using this system modeling to implement predictive maintenance or optimize chemical usage, optimize energy usage, etc. For more information, feel free to reach out to me. I'm Tom Craven. You can reach me at the email address there. You can also send an email to info@RRAMAC.com or visit our website at www.RRAMAC.com. Thanks for listening.